Okay, so here is another brittle Coulomb Moore slash modified Moore brittle failure theory example. What the hell just happened here? Let me get the page out though before I do that. All right, so in this one, not too much different from the previous one, we have ASTM 30 cast iron. And we already looked up that in tension, it's got 31 KSI in tensile strength, but in compression, we have 109, so more than three times the amount here. And so for this stress state, we have 35 KSI compression, 13 in tension, and we're calling this negative, which will be down. So writing that out right here. We see that we have compression here, 35 KSI. We have tension here of 13 KSI. And I guess it's going to go that direction. I think that's correct for shear. So we have 10 KSI in shear. And if I do my Mohr circle here onto this thing, and I'm doing a very miniature version of the thing. We're gonna have 13 and 10 on this face right here. So like right there and there. And then we're gonna have 35 and 10 over here and on this face. So that's much further up and over. So something along those lines right here. So we can expect a C. That's going to be negative right in there. And here's my big Mohr circle. Whoop, it's a lopsided Mohr circle. There you go. Make that a little bit better. Something like that. And then recognize there's another Mohr circle right here and right here. I draw this. Okay, something like that. But here is C. And then this is the side I'm going to use for R because it's easier. I don't like to use the side that's crossing over there. So we're going to get a sigma A and a sigma B. So my C is going to be 30, excuse me, I'll go 13 plus a negative 35, or there you go. Eventually, I was going to get it right. So we end up with a negative 11. And then for my R here, I'm going to take, I guess I'll take that 35 and subtract out the 11 right here. And that'll give me this leg right here. And then for the vertical leg, it's just going to be that 10 squared. So I end up getting 26. So my sigma A is the C plus R. The negative 11 and the 26, so I get 15. That's supposed to be a 15. You can barely see that. 15 KSI. And for B, I get a C minus R. I end up getting a negative 37, so that's compression. For my brittle Coulomb Moore, and we are definitely in the quadrant where we care about it, right? With the 15 and the 37, so we're in the bottom right-hand quadrant, the fourth quadrant, I guess we call that, right? So we can use this equation right here. And because we're down here into this quadrant. And so we take sigma A divided by the tension strength, and sigma B and the compression strength. And that minus right there, its sole purpose is because this is going to be a negative value. So you do add them up together, right? So don't think that this is actually subtracting right there. So we have 15, we just found. And 31 minus our minus 37 and divide by 109. And so, of course, we have to take the reciprocal of that when we get it. So the brittle Coulomb more ends up being 1.22. Now for the modified more, we should really take a look and see if we are below the 45 degree line. So this line right here is where the brittle Coulomb more, the modified more takes off. Otherwise, if you're up above this right here, right, you just go ahead and take the ultimate strength and divide it by the positive of the two principal stresses, and that's going to give you your safety factor. But if you're below this line right here, which is they're calling the torsion line, that ratio of B to A. And so what is the ratio of the B to A? I'll write it over here somewhere. I think this part is safe right here. Sigma B over sigma A is going to be 37 over 15. And that is definitely larger than 1, which is the slope, right, for the 45. So we have 37 divided by 15. So at 2.467, which is definitely greater than 1. Therefore, we use this equation right here, which is a bit longish, but you're taking the difference between the two strengths, multiply by A, and divide by both the compression and the tension strength, and then you subtract, but remember that subtraction is really because that's negative right there, and then we can find this is going to be the modified more safety factor. So I wrote it out here. I didn't rewrite out the equation though. So that's 109 minus 31 times our 15 and divided by our 109 and 31, and then minus, but a minus 37 and divided by 109. And we get a modified more safety factor at 1.46. So let's see what that looks like on the failure loci. I'm going to do a better job than I did in the previous video. That's my goal here. So here is my axis. And I already know my breakout of, purposely made it here. Here's my 31, like right in there. So this is not necessary, this part of it's, we're not going to use it for any other purposes, but to look, just to look pretty. Now these are by 20s, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, and then we're going to go to 109, which is close to 110, it's like right there. Same thing here. Crooked there. All right, so these are the important ones though. First off, we'll draw from here to here. Let me just try to make that as accurate as possible. Double check my pencil thickness. Pretty good. This one doesn't matter, but it's just for looks. Now we're going to do the, that's the brittle Coulomb more. Now we do the modified more. Remember, we're going to go to down to 31 right there. Right. So that actually it comes to somewhere right in there. I'll draw these as a dashed line. This is a dashed line too. Not great, not terrible. Just for looks, symmetry, what have you. I'm gonna go this one first then. Go that direction. Dash, 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 dash. And then this one. And then we're going to plot out our points. We have 15 and negative 37. So 15. These are counting by fours. So here's 4, 8, 12, 16. 15 should be like right in there. Right? Because there's 12, 13, 14. Yeah, maybe is it closer to that? Yeah, something like that. Like to 16. Okay. And then we have to go negative 37. So here is 20. Here's so 22. No, 24, 28, 32, 36. Right. So it's really right there. So let's draw a thin line right there. And that guy's like right here too. So right there is about where our point is going to be. Once again, I'm going to call this O. I'm going to try to draw a straight line, as straight line as I can. Use the pencil. Check out the pencil thickness. Boom. So this is A. This is B. And right there is C. Measuring through here, we get close to 35. Let's see, how close are we? 35, I'm gonna say 34. OA is approximately 34 millimeters. When you're crazy, you get the calipers out. You get your digital calipers out and measure the thing just to go a little nuts. This looks like it's either 41 or 42. 41, 42. I'm going to say that it's 42. And then OC. It's going to be, ooh, that looks almost exactly 50 to me. I don't know. 49. So our safety factor for brittle Coulomb-Moore is going to be the OB over OA, or 42 over 34. And let's see, make sure that's approximate. 42 and 34, 1.235, call it 1.24. And for the modified Moore, that's going to be the OC, that distance, divided by OA. So that's 49 divided by 34. 49, 34, divide. We get 1.441 and change. So compare. 1.22, 1.24. 1.46, 1.44, I think it's justifiable. I think it's correct. So this was problem 525 from the 10th edition. Yeah. And I'll do another example maybe. I don't know. Did a lot of examples. No, this is enough. 15 minutes of video too.